The brain on a chip is an integrated experimental platform whereby we have neurons and brain cells that are in a recording device which incorporates microelectrodes. A key use of this brain on a chip is to understand how human cells function and respond to different types of therapeutics and different types of chemicals. The microelectrodes in our devices pick up the signals that are being generated by the neurons. When the neurons communicate with one another, they evoke small electrical signals that are picked up by these microelectrodes. These microelectrodes allow us to listen in on the conversation of the neurons. The brain on a chip consists of a few different pieces. One is a microphysiological device. So this is a device in which cells are cultured and they can be maintained and are viable for weeks at a time. Ideally, they would function as they would in the body. These cells are grown on top of these multi-electrode arrays. And these electrodes are able to pick up the minute electrical signals that these neurons generate when they talk to one another. So by having an array of these electrodes across the device and having cells grown across these arrays, we can then understand how these neurons talk with one another and how they form intricate networks. And this is essential so that we can understand if we then add a chemical compound or a therapeutic, how does that compound affect how these neurons talk to one another. And understanding how they talk to one another and how that's disrupted, especially in the context of human cells, allows us to develop better countermeasures and better therapeutics. There's a lot of expertise here at the laboratory that's being leveraged to develop these brain-on-a-chip devices. The engineering directorate has a long history of developing implantable microelectrode arrays that can be used to understand how cells and neurons are functioning, both in animals, in humans, as well as in cells cultured on a chip. There's also a lot of biological expertise here at the laboratory in developing assays to understand how cells communicate with one another and how chemicals and therapeutics impact the way these cells function. So the next step that we're working on now in developing our brain on a chip is to incorporate complex architecture into our neuronal cultures. Our brains are our three-dimensional structures, and the connections and interactions between cells happens in a three-dimensional space. So we are currently developing novel devices where we have electrodes that can probe this 3D space and can then start to understand how this three-dimensionality impacts the function of these neurons and also what happens when chemicals are added. How different is this 3D culture from the traditional 2D culture? And to better understand how the human brain works, we really need to work on recapitulating the architecture.